More than 1 million Americans with diabetes have had to ration their insulin in the last year, thanks to soaring costs. Well, here, this is a policy failure. I mean, this is a top-of-the-line policy failure. You know, there was all this celebration when Congress comes out and say, we've done it. We're controlling the pharmaceutical industry. Nonsense. That is the biggest bunch of bunk I've ever heard delivered. And what it came down to is they said, we have 12 items that we're going to control prices on. And oh, by the way, if a product hasn't been on the market more than 12 years, we can't do anything about it, right?
Yeah.
So pick that up with insulin in mind.
Insulin, you know, obviously this is not a life-saving drug. This is a life-sustaining drug.
Yes.
They will die without it. 1.3 million people in the last 12 months have said, I've had to ration it. I can't afford it. Mm. And this is, as we have talked about so many times, a uniquely American problem. This doesn't happen anywhere else on the planet other than within our borders, because we choose as a country to let this happen. The politicians have made the choice, and they have said, we're gonna let the pharmaceutical companies do whatever they want, charge whatever they want, take as much money from us to subsidize their research as they want, and then there's no controls.
Let me talk about that just a second. Eli Lilly, now you talk about R&D basic, subsidized research. But that's a ridiculous, I mean, you know that's ridiculous. You've done stories on the whole research and development, how stupid that argument is. Let me put it in terms of how stupid it is, okay? Eli Lilly has had their insulin product on the market since 1996. All the research is done. All the development is done. But nevertheless, they have raised the price 680%. As of today, 680%. There is no argument. There's no argument that it's about research and development. It's about advertising, okay?
Yep.
Now, which brings me to the next point. You know, there's only one other country on the entire globe that allows the pharmaceutical company to go on TV and say, hey, tell your doctor you want this new drug. It's New Zealand and it's the United States. And that has a big impact on the prices of these drugs, because they're spending gazillion dollars with MSNBC and CNN and ABC, you know, to make that happen.
You know, and it's interesting because we've been talking about the direct-to-consumer advertising since, I think, 2004 on Ring of Fire.
Yeah.
And what happened is doctors were furious, and they still are, but I think most of them have almost been bought off at this point by the pharmaceutical industry. But doctors were mad at the time because instead of patients coming in and saying what was wrong and the doctor giving recommendations, patients came in like they were ordering from McDonald's, saying, listen, okay, I want Celebrex, I want some Vioxx, I want all these things. The people on the commercial were so happy, I want to feel happy too.
Right.
And doctors were furious when this first all started coming together. And like I said, now they get paid off by the pharmaceutical
companies.
And
it affects the price of insulin.
Yeah.
Or anything, because they build that into their pricing structure. Again, Eli Lilly, since 1996, has made this, put it on the market. No research and development since 1996. It's raised 680%. Zero possibility of a reason.
And they can do it, too, because they know this isn't a drug. Yeah, it's not a baldness drug that people say, well, I guess I'm not going to do it. This is a drug that people have to take or they die.
Yeah.
Or they die.
And they're splitting, they're rationing. Do I eat? Do I buy clothes? Or do I buy insulin to stay alive? It's a pathetic story. Oh, good news here. California, you know, every now and then they come up with a great idea. Yeah. They said, hell with that. We're gonna produce our own insulin. I mean, I love that. You just got to love that.
Yeah.